गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स,
टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द सेम लेसन, लेसन नंबर 7, फूड एंड न्यूट्रिशन।
ओके, सो लेट्स हैव अ क्विक रिवीजन ऑफ व्हाट वी हैव लर्न इन द लास्ट वीडियो। व्हाट वी हैव लर्न इन द लास्ट वीडियो, वी लर्न अबाउट स्टेपल फूड, यस। वी लर्न अबाउट वेराइटी इन फूड स्टफ्स, यस। वी लर्न फ्यू क्वेश्चंस, व्हाई वी नीड फूड and why there is variation in the diet. Yes, we have learned what does diet mean. All these things we have learned in the last video. Also, we learned that how different foodstuffs are used for preparing different items. Yes, okay. So, this we have learned, variety in foodstuff. And see, these are all variety in foodstuff. These are all foodstuffs which we have learned in the last video. Also, we have gone through this. That from what thing what we get from milk, we get butter, we get flour from jawar, bajra, all this we have seen. Okay, for giving a dish sour taste, what we use, for giving a sweet taste, what we use. Yes, we have learned all this in the last video. Now let's move further. Just as there is variety in the foodstuff we use, there are differences in people like and dislike. As we have seen that there is variety in foodstuff, there are a lot of foodstuffs, see this all we have seen. But like that only, there is people's like and dislike also. Few people like something, whereas that same thing is not liked by someone else. Yes, see in this picture, this kid is so happy eating his meal. Okay, see this kid in the second picture, he is not happy with his food. Okay, that means he doesn't like that food. Okay, so there is difference between the like and dislike of people. Okay, we tend to eat and we eat the items we like again and again. Like small kids, they like burger, pizza and like french fries. So they are very happy to eat it. Yes, see this girl, she is so happy eating a burger. You can see a burger in her hand. Okay, we also tend to always avoid what we don't like. Okay, that is habit of a human being, that he avoids what he does not like, he avoid it. He does not eat it again. Yes. Now see this kid in the second picture. He is not happy with his food. That means he does not like it and he is avoiding to eat it. Okay. He is going to eat very less or he will not eat only. Okay. So this is the difference. Okay. As there is variety in foodstuff, there is like and dislike also people. However, the most important thing is to ensure that the food related needs of our body are all being met. Okay, we should eat everything whatever our mother prepares at home. Okay, because we get some or the other good thing or benefit from that food. Yes, for our body gets energy and it becomes strong. It gets all the nutrition which it requires. Yes. So see, these are the various nutrients which are there in the body: water, carbohydrate, fat, protein, vitamin, mineral and fiber. We will learn this later in detail in the next standard or in the next chapters, not now. This is only the basic thing you have to remember, that there are so many things in our body which we get from food we eat. Yes. The food constituents that meet the different needs of our body are present in all our foodstuffs in varying quantities. Now the food constituents means what? Whatever you eat. Okay, the food constituent that meet the different needs of our body, okay, are present in all our foodstuff in varying quantities. Okay, food constituent means what? Now I have shown you this man with the different names. Okay, with what mineral and protein we get from which food. Okay, so these are the food constituents, okay, which our body requires to become strong. These are all constituents of food. Okay, we get these constituents from different food. Okay, we eat different food. So in different food, these constituents are present in different quantity, different amount. Okay, in some they are less, in some they are more. Okay. See here, we eat so many things. Okay, from one thing only we don't get all the protein and all the vitamin. We have to eat all different things. Okay, because different thing have different constituents in different amount. Okay.
Some of these constituents give our body energy it need. Now, different constituents work in different ways. Now, some give you energy which you require when you work. Different work, all the day you work in office or maybe at home. Also work like respiration and digestion of food goes on inside our body. Okay, we play. Okay, we do work, we play, and we do respiration and digestion also our body do. For that also, we need energy. Okay, the body needs energy for all this work. So, from where do we get this? From food we get. Okay. This is the first point. Second one, about constituents. Some constituents helps our body to grow. Because we eat some constituents, we grow. Okay. And because of some, they help to repair the wear and tear of our body that take place in everyday work. Now, what is wear and tear? Wear and tear means you get injury sometimes, okay, while working, you fall down, okay. So, it repairs some proteins which you eat, you get from your food. It repairs your wear and tear also, that injuries also, okay. Third point, some food constituent help to nourish our body. It helps to grow your body. Okay, it helps to create a store of substance that give energy to our body. Okay, now some constituents, what they do, they get stored in the body. And they come in use whenever they are required by the body. Okay, now see fats, protein, vitamin, mineral, carbohydrate, so many things are there. Now fats, what do? They get stored in the body. Okay, whenever your body needs to do some work, the fat gives you energy. Okay, understood. Fourth one. Some food constituents are necessary for special reason. Certain special reason. What are the special reason? For example, like for bones, you eat calcium. Okay, you drink milk. You eat cheese. All these things have calcium in it. Some constituent make our bones strong. Means for bones, you have to eat things which have calcium. Okay. Now, some constituent give the body the ability to fight with disease. Now, some fruits or vegetables are there which help in fighting with the diseases. Like turmeric is there, ginger is there, garlic is there. They fight with diseases. Yes? See here. For strong bones, what should you eat? Salmon, sesame seeds, yogurt, milk, cheese, tofu, spinach, white beans, sardines. Okay? All these are the things which you have to eat for the bones. Okay? You can search in Google if you want to know about them in detail. Foods to boost immune system means they ability to fight with disease. Okay, now you are aware about the disease which is there in the surrounding corona. For that, people are saying that improve your immunity system. Okay, eat things which improve your immunity. That means you will be able to fight with the disease. Okay, that is why you have to eat all these things. Papaya, citric foods. Okay, turmeric, carrot, garlic, ginger. Okay. Fifth point. And for all the function of our body to go on smoothly, we need to drink plenty of water. The most important thing after eating, you have to drink lot of water. Not lot, means how much is required by your body, that much only you drink. Because it fights with the infection, it keeps you energized. Okay, it helps in digestion. It helps in protecting your headaches and it flush out all the toxin and bad things from your body. Okay, it improves the skin, your health. Okay, so these are the benefits of water. Sixth point, if our body is to work properly, it must remain healthy. Okay, so we must include all the food constituents in our body. Now for your body to be strong. Okay, you have to eat proper food. All the food you have to eat what your mother gives you. All types of food, I mean to say. Okay. And don't eat like unhealthy foods like burgers and all. That is unhealthy food. Okay, because it is made outside your home. Okay. Whatever your mother prepares, that is healthy food. Okay. Next. We get all these food constituents from different foodstuff in different quantity. Yes, we understood this that we get constituents, that protein, vitamins. Constituents means that protein, vitamin which give you
which give you nutrition for your body that we get from various foodstuffs. There are so many different foodstuffs from which we get them in different quantity. Okay, that is why we keep using different foodstuff in our daily meal. Do you eat one thing only every day? Okay, no na. Do you eat dosa every day? No. Sometime you eat some other food, sometime you eat some other food. Do you eat same vegetable every day? No. You have to change your diet every day. Okay. Some things remain same like chapati and rice because they are the staple food. Okay. Such a diet ensures proper nourishment for the body. Okay. For your body to get nourished, for the growth and your development of your body, you have to eat different kinds of food. Not only the same food every day. Okay. Which give you all these things. All the nutritions to your body. So this much only for today, students. Thank you so much. Do like, comment and share for more videos. And do not forget to subscribe my channel.